did you, like, did something bad happen? Why did you leave? I feel like you just got there. Hey everyone, welcome back. So as you can see, I am here in my apartment in the United States. I am no longer in Japan. And in this video, I wanted to talk a little bit about why I left Japan and what I plan on doing next. So we're gonna get into that. But first, I wanted to share some of my highlights about Japan because it was an amazing experience. And you guys know I filmed a ton of videos. I still have a bunch in my backlog that I'm going to release, so definitely stay tuned for that. But yeah, I wanted to talk about some highlights. So why did I go to Japan in the first place? I went to study at a Japanese language school, and it was my dream for many, many years to live in Japan, go to a Japanese school, really experience that, like, anime school life that I think so many people who grow up watching anime want to experience. And I did that. So I studied at a Japanese language school. It was really, really difficult. It was far more difficult than I expected. It was definitely worth it. And now I can, well, I've achieved one of my long-term goals, which was to be able to play Japanese import games without needing a translation guide or needing to use like Google Translate or something like that. So yeah, it's amazing that now I can really understand the majority of what's going on, especially in games that are geared more towards kids. So like Pokemon or Metabots, games like that, that are a little bit more aged down. For really advanced games like Yakuza or something like that, there's a ton of crazy kanji in there and I don't know what the heck is going on. But all that's to say, I hit that goal, so that was amazing. And then obviously to just live in Japan and be able to go shopping in Akihabara, living in Tokyo, shopping in Ikebukuro, that's where I was living, was amazing. So I did so much Gunpla shopping as well as retro game hunting, many of which I've made videos for, which you guys seem to be enjoying. So that's been awesome. I also went to the Shizuoka Hobby Show, which was, in addition to, you know, living in Japan and going to school, I had always wanted to go to the Shizuoka Hobby Show. If you guys remember way, way back in the day on YouTube, there was a Hobby Link Japan channel. I think there still is. And they would cover the Shizuoka Hobby Show in the early days of YouTube. And I just thought it was so cool and I always wanted to go. And so I did. I went last March to the Shizuoka Hobby Show and I made a video on it, which I'll link to here. And it was amazing. It was a dream come true. Shizuoka is gorgeous. If you guys don't know, that's where Mount Fuji is in Japan. So it's a pretty famous region of Japan. And they also house, or Shizuoka City has Tamiya factory and a bunch of other plastic model headquarters for companies there. It's known as like the plastic model capital of Japan or of the world sometimes. And yeah, it was such a cool experience. And yeah, I don't know what else to say other than that. It was, again, like a dream come true. So I really enjoyed that. So what else? The arcades. I went to a ton of Japanese arcades and played so many retro games and modern Japanese arcade games. Again, I did a few videos on those. I'll link to those down below as well. But the arcades were amazing. The retro game shops were amazing. Going to all of the book-offs and hard-offs and Surugayas, that was incredible. Akihabara less so because it's kind of, I mean, it's always been very touristy, but now, especially in 2024, it is like peak Japan tourism right now. And so there weren't too many crazy deals, if deals at all, but it was still really fun to just be in that environment. I think Akihabara is more about the environment really than getting deals. It's an experience. So that was amazing. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I just wanted to have a little overview about some highlights that I experienced in Japan. And now I can talk really quickly about my future plans for the channel. So I'm gonna continue doing store tours because I really enjoy them. And I'm gonna go to retro game shops here in the United States and model shops here in the United States, maybe hobby shows or retro game expos, things like anime expos. Definitely gonna cover those. And also, I have a big backlog of videos I filmed in Japan that I haven't released yet, including one really, really exciting one. So definitely don't worry, the Japan content is not over. Also, I plan on going back. Like, I love being there. I went there before I lived there, and I'll be there again after. So, yeah, there's plenty more to come. But just getting into why I left. So some people were asking me, like, hey, did something bad happen? Why did you leave? I feel like you just got there. And I never really planned to stay long term. I saved up for probably about 3 years to have enough money to live in Japan while continuing to pay for my apartment here in the United States. So I did that. But as you would imagine, it's really expensive to basically have two apartments and not have a job. So I went to school for a couple of terms. And when those terms were completed, I came back to the United States because you're actually not allowed to stay. As soon as your school term ends, if you don't continue and enroll in another school term, you have to leave the country within, I think, a 2-week window. So that's basically what I did. I did have a 2-year visa, so I could have stayed longer, but I just couldn't afford it. I had to come back and get a job so I could continue to pay for my apartment and just pay for life and things like that. So yeah, I had always planned on staying for a very brief period of time. So nothing bad happened. It was a really amazing experience. And yeah, everything pretty much went according to plan. Like, I made YouTube videos. I got way better at Japanese. I got to enjoy amazing Japanese food. I traveled. I went to, like I said, Shizuoka, and I went to Yokohama. And yeah, I don't know. I just wanted to make a little update video to tell you guys all I'm back and to share those future plans for the channel. And yeah, I don't want this to go on for too long. So without further ado, I will see you guys in the next video. And one more thing, I now offer channel memberships where I have a bunch of exclusive videos, additional Japan videos, all kinds of different stuff. So I'm doing that instead of a Patreon. It's a great way to support the channel. If you guys are interested, definitely click the link at the top of my page and consider becoming a channel member. It starts at a really, really low price, and there's a few different tiers based on how much you would want to give to the channel. So definitely consider checking that out. And also, if you want to chat and hang out with me and everyone else in this community, definitely consider joining the Discord. We have a Pixelly Discord, and it's totally free. There's a link at the top of the page as well, and you can just come and hang out and talk Gunpla and retro games and anime and all kinds of stuff. And we would love to have you there. It's an awesome group of people. And one more thing, definitely consider following me on Whatnot. I am going to be doing some Whatnot streams in the near future. I'll have specifics about a date soon, but I'm going to be doing some cool streams on there where I maybe do some Gunpla building or retro gaming, and then maybe auction off a few interesting rare and obscure items while that's going on. So it's a new format I'm going to be trying out, so definitely stay tuned. I'll put the link to my Whatnot page down below, so if you want to follow me there, then you'll get notified when I'm going to schedule my stream or show or whatever you call it. I'm new to the platform, but yeah, I'll put that link below too, so definitely follow me on Whatnot. And that is it. I appreciate you guys watching, and definitely hit the thumbs up and subscribe if you enjoyed this, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.